So let's see, where do we start? We just finished a trip to Kauai, you and I.
Right.
And I watched the Kauai interview, as I told you, that we did from the Sheraton. And it was beautifully done, Gustavo. Thank you very much. The other thing we just got finished doing, you and I, was we just finished an advanced study weekend, which to me was kind of like a symphony. It people came up to me and they said, well, I go to many health conferences, and so I have a lot of experience at going to health conferences. And then a few people said, but there's nothing like a McDougall advanced study weekend. And I would agree. I mean, it's just kind of like a symphony played from Friday until Sunday. It all were done. And those of you who are there and those of you who are watching online clearly know this. This was an amazing event. I'm glad that I was able to be the orchestrator. And it, you know, I think everybody there and everybody watching on the internet, and by the way, you could still watch it on the internet. You just go to the advanced study weekend and it is not free. But yeah, it was phenomenal, and to do it without you being there, Gustavo, would be a big miss. And without all the guests we had, there's not a one of them who did not fulfill all of our expectations. And as you know, if you attended or you watched, some of the speakers took us high, and some of them brought us back down to earth. Some of the key lectures I put up on our website for free. And that's because my goal is to change the world. And so I can't do it without providing information that is generally my information solely. So I have sole permission to share it. Sharing information with anybody on the internet for free, that's what the internet's all about. And as a result, this morning, which is February 16, 2017, we put out the lecture, which is freely available right now at the moment, from the website drmcdougall.com. You look under education videos, and you look under e-lectures, I believe, and you'll find the top lecture is about the newest scams from the diabetes industry. You know, it's all there. It's all free. Share it with your diabetologist, share it with your favorite drug rep, share it with anybody you want. It's all free and available. So people say, well, why do I pay for all the money to go to the advanced study weekend or to buy it online? And the answer is because it's, in my opinion, well worth the trouble, but you're the customer. I am going to give you free information from myself. Likely we'll put up from Friday evening, February 10th. That'll likely be going up. And for certain, Mary's two lectures will be free and accessible sometime in the near future from our website. These are crucial lectures on how to plan your meals that Mary did an amazing job. And also on how to eat out.
Superb.
And
Yeah.
crucial
Actually,
time.
Dr. McDougall, those lectures are already up.
Oh, okay, they're already up. Good. Fine.
They're
The
great.
staff is ahead of me.
They're ahead.
But the one we publicized this morning, we sent to all of our newsletter subscribers, was the diabetic one. And even though they're already up, we will send you through the newsletter notification about each and every one of these free lectures from the advanced study weekend. And I don't know whether I probably won't put any other lectures up. So you will not see Nick Delgado, who was, what do you think? Absolutely amazing, Gustavo.
That was we all left completely energized. It was incredible.
Breathless may be the word, yeah.
Just
And then Kevin Hall, people still don't figure out why I invited Kevin Hall from the NIH. You will understand.
Yes.
Anyway,
There
there
is a
was
motive. There
Dr.
is a reason behind you, behind
Oh,
it.
yeah.
Yeah, Andrew Taylor was also a wonderful presenter.
Oh, it was amazing.
Yeah.
You know, he's life-changing, but Dr. Agarwal and Dr. Van Ecken and Dr. Rudolph and Dr. Lim. And, you know, I hate to start mentioning names because you're going to say, well, you forgot one of the
And
most
yeah, you
important
forgot
ones.
exactly. No, but
But
what you were saying earlier is true. I mean, when you go to the event in person, there's so much depth to it because you get to meet all these wonderful people. I mean, I always make just amazing friends and connections. And of course, we get to try the food that you don't get to try if you're not there.
And you get to meet everybody. I mean, every speaker
Right,
is very friendly.
right.
But
They're very friendly.
folks, as I'm pushing this for you, I just want you to know there are no advanced study weekends
I
scheduled,
know.
at least in my mind. If you look on the website, there's a date listed for 2018. But excuse me, that's not with my approval.
That's not with your
So
approval.
no. So as far as you should be concerned, the advanced study weekends, I have no plans for the future. Doesn't mean I'm not going to do them. Doesn't mean I'm going to do them. I just need a break.
You
And
do.
I don't need a break in time in terms of slowing down or retiring. I need a break in the sense that we need to go in a more progressive direction, and therefore advanced study weekends and trips to around the world to Kauai and Galapagos and Costa Rica and Alaska and the Big Island, excuse me, are just put on hold. I have no plans for doing them. But clearly, ladies and gentlemen, Dr. McDougall is not retiring. He is still fully in the room and will move forward at a pace that hopefully will leave you breathless.
Exactly.
Anyway, that just to give you focus, we're running 10-day programs as we always do. Myself, I will be there for patients as Dr. Lim will be. We're running a couple of intensive weekends. I just don't want you to get confused about the message, but you should take advantage of everything that we've done so far. It's all for on the website, pretty much. Shall we talk about diabetes
Yes,
before?
of course. Yes, Dr. McDougall, that this is such an important topic for so many people, and of course, we've gotten requests as to if you would please clarify the differences between type 1, type 2, type 1.5, and how the starch solution or a starch-based diet helps each one of them, and anything else you want to talk about,
Thank you.
people, yeah.
Thank you. First of all, it's all free
Right.
in the January 2017 newsletter on my website, drmcdougall.com. Plus the lecture, which I'm going to repeat a little bit of right now. It's a repeat. The lecture is free on the website, drmcdougall.com, under education, videos, e-lectures probably. It's free there. The latest scams from the diabetes industries. So you can watch it. You can say, well, Dr. McDougall said the same thing on the webinar. Yeah, I did. I only know a certain number of things. You can also share it with friends. I encourage you to use social media to help Gustavo and I change the world. And all we can do is kind of lay the material out for you. It's your job to send it to friends and relatives and doctors and pharmacists and pharmaceutical companies and heads of state and government officials and the FDA, whatever you want. Anyway, we had a good time talking about diabetes on Sunday morning, February 12th, 2017. In fact, it really wasn't the morning; it was afternoon. So, I, as a medical doctor, gave you some focus of attention that I'd like to give you again. I want you to know when you look at me is that I am a medical doctor. I'm a board certified internist. I am not an alternative medicine. I'm not a holistic doctor. I'm just a regular old board certified internist. And I've been taking care of diabetes. It's the reason you ought to believe me. When I talk to you about patients' use, I would throw my most credibility card out to you in the fact that I have personally seen more than 10,000 people and
Right.
help them with their medical care over nearly a half a century. In fact, I could say that probably over 4 decades. And over the last 4 decades, not only have I personally touched, but I have locked up in the nicest jails you can find. I've locked up 6,000 people and helped them make other decisions in terms of their medications, their future surgeries, their food and so on. So you say, well, why should I believe Dr. McDougall and as opposed to ex-guru or this vegan expert or this low carber. Let me throw that card on the table for you. Is in terms of medical practice, I'm the real deal. All right, so you're my patient. And the only way you get to become my patient is you attend a 10-day program. And you walk in as a person on a bag full of drugs, which they always, almost always do. They bring in a bag full of drugs and a little hope. And, well, they have hope, but their past history really gives them little hope if they relied on that, because they've seen where they've been in the past. They've seen the support they've gotten from their medical doctors, with exceptions, by the way. There are many medical doctors who don't apply to what I have to say, but in general, they do. They've gone to see their medical doctor. The doctor has given them a bunch of excuses and a bag full of drugs. And they can see it. The patient can see it. And by the way, the doctors and dietitians, they can see it too. They can see what they've offered the patient, which is a bunch of excuses and a bag full of drugs. Well, I had the great fortune, and many of you who are interested can follow my journey, understand my journey, but I've had the great fortune to be become knowledgeable about what I'm doing in terms of drug therapy and knowledgeable about what I'm doing in terms of food. Well, anyway, you walk in the door, 10-day program. You're on a bag full of drugs, a few shots of insulin, and let's just say you're really thin. So my guess is you're a type 1 diabetic, and I leave you on your insulin. Very important. Type 1 diabetics absolutely require insulin. So I leave you on your insulin, but I adjust the dose maybe down 30%. So you're taking 70% of the insulin as when you came in. I stop pills if you're type 1 diabetic. But of course, I keep you on insulin, which may be in various types of dosing regimes. But I have to reduce the dose, plus I tell you to go back to your room and make sure you have sugar, carbohydrate, chocolate pudding, candy bars, typical diabetic rescue foods, so that if you get hypoglycemia, you'll be able to treat it immediately without calling the ambulance. So you have to reduce the medication if you're type 1 diabetic by about 30 when you change the food. I'm going to leave type 1 diabetes totally alone. I'm your doctor. You walk into the clinic. You are overweight. You are on insulin or not on insulin. You could be taking 140 units of insulin. You could be taking four of the most expensive diabetic medications on the market. And I take a look at you and I say, let's see. I think, remember, I've been doing this for 40 years. I'm not always right, but I certainly deserve the right to take my best guess. That's what doctors do, is guess. So I look at you and I go, hey, I think you're a type 2 diabetic. And so what I want you to do is I want you to stop all of your pills and all of your insulin. You go, whoa, you know, where did I arrive? Is this okay? Can I trust him? Most people come with expectations and trust, and they're disappointed if I don't stop their drugs. But occasionally somebody doesn't feel that way. And yeah, we can negotiate, but remember hypoglycemia. I don't want you falling over in your oatmeal the next morning at breakfast because your sugar's too low. Anyway, that's what I guess on type 2 diabetes. Then there's a spectrum in between called type 1.5 diabetes. In other words, you make enough insulin in your body to keep you out of the hospital, to keep you out of ketoacidosis, which is very serious. But you don't make enough insulin to cover all your needs. You have partial pancreatic insufficiency. And how do I know that? Well, I'm guessing. In time, I will know. Produce enough insulin, what will happen in time is you'll lose the excess weight, which is causing type 2 diabetes. It's causing insulin resistance and type 2 diabetes. So you lose the excess weight, so you've gotten rid of insulin resistance, and if you're type 2, you're cured 100% of the time. But if that's not the case, say you're partially pancreatic insufficient, then what we're dealing with is after you lose, say, half a person, or maybe 50 pounds, or 150 pounds, you can do the kilo conversions, and you're down to trim body weight, and you keep losing, you know, instead of 6 feet tall and 150 pounds, you become 6 foot tall and 130 pounds. And that's too much weight loss. That tells me that your pancreas is not making enough insulin. We'll supplement you with long-acting insulin. Lantus is my drug of choice. There are other long-acting insulins. I'll give you a little insulin enough to slow, stop the weight loss or to cause you weight gain if necessary. Insulin is necessary to put fat into fat cells. It's a necessary drug for those, for everybody, but especially for those with insufficiency. So I will give you a little Lantus insulin. You can use other kinds. If you lose too much weight, if you develop symptoms of diabetes, such as excess urination, and or if you worry about the numbers, which people do, and sort of their doctors, et cetera, hey, I'm a real doctor. I can give you a shot of insulin. I can take your emotional worries. But I don't say that glibly. I seriously mean it. Three reasons to treat 1.5 diabetes is if they lose too much weight, develop symptoms of diabetes, and or worry about the numbers. So I said all that about diabetic medical care. I just want to add, Gustavo, before we go to questions, is you can cure type 2 diabetes with any form of weight loss. You can cure it with low-carb diets, which, by the way, make you sick, these diets, and the planet sick. These are diets of meat, cheese, and bacon. Yeah, they'll cure type 2 diabetes. Yes, you can do bariatric surgery. I gave you a whole list of ways to cause weight loss, but the most effective, safe, healthiest way to lose weight and get your health back is with a starch-based diet. The diet that I have been teaching you for a long time, it's the tastiest, most effective way to permanently lose weight loss, get your life back, and save the animals. And I'd like to stop there, Gustavo.
Okay. All right. Very good. Dr. McDougall, you said something that I think it's so important to just highlight one more time, what you just said. There's a lot of ways to lose weight, but they're not healthy, particularly. They don't enhance the person's health, and the diet that you recommend is what makes a big difference. Would you like to show any of the slides before we go to do any questions?
You know, I didn't do it. We were going to, but they're all PowerPoint presentation slides that are you can watch on the video. So
okay.
instead of stepping back and doing what we planned, let's just tell them again. You can watch the whole video. All the slides are there. It's free. If you need the scientific references, they are attached to links. You don't have to look it up. They're attached to links in my January 2017 newsletter. And again, both are free without gimmicks. You find the gimmick, you let us know.
Yes.
Anyway, we just hope to engage you to fight a war to reclaim. What do we say, Gustavo? To make America great again.
That's right.
to win the war for people and the planet. And yes, there may be a few people in the drug and food industry that are looking for new jobs, but that happened with the tobacco industry 30 years ago.
Exactly.
At least in the United States, they had to look for new jobs. They just promoted their their marketing to Asia and Africa. But
right.
Hey. You know, not all of us have the same moral compass to follow.
Well, when this webinar goes out, when the replay goes out, it will have the links to all the newsletters and the videos from the advanced study, everything, so people can then really zero in and watch it. How about if we answer a few questions? If you actually answer a few questions, why are many people told to be afraid of beans and rice? Adelina is asking here on the webinar.
Stupidity, ignorance, profit, greed, money. I did a lecture. Many of you know that I've spent a good share of my career working with the Seventh-day Adventists. I am not a Seventh-day Adventist, but part of their mission statement, which has been around for more than 150 years, dates back to Ellen White, The mission statement, which by the way is in the lobby of St. Lita Hospital where I used to work, the mission statement is something to the effect that we are going to help people with their health by changing their bad habits and their diet. But as I discussed with this very public radio show host in the Adventist community, as I discussed with him, and hopefully all the Adventists get this, is the mission statement stops in the lobby of the hospital. That's where it stops. And from there on, all the way to the hospital cafeteria and the cath labs and the chemo wards and et cetera, all the things to keep the doors of St. Lena Hospital open. It's the money. I did mention it was the money. I told this host it's a five-letter word. He kept saying, no, it's ignorance, which is, I can't count the letters, but yeah, maybe ignorance, but that's not it. Because this information has been available, verifiable for thousands of years. In fact, the Adventists do believe in the Bible and even the Old Testament. So the research goes back, controlled trial for thousands of years. And before that, it goes back to the pharaohs of, you can't claim ignorance. You cannot claim ignorance. If you're a patient or a doctor or a dietitian or a pharmacy or a pharmaceutical company or a hospital, that's a lame excuse. Yeah. Greed and money, those are fine. I'll buy that, but don't tell me ignorance.
So, you know, sometimes I think it's a combination of ignorance and just maybe a little laziness, because at this time in history, when we have access to so much information, it's becoming up to us to take care of our health. I mean, and not leaving it up entirely to the God of, you know, the doctor.
It's to who has the most money, Gustavo.
That's right. That's right.
And that is changing. There was an article in today's news, and I wish I would have brought it in for you, but maybe Mary will bring it in. She's watching. An article in today's news about a wealthy person in the food industry deciding that he was going to start a march for truth, and has engaged Michael Jacobson from the Physicians Committee for Responsible Medicine. The Center for Science and the Public Interest. Please get that correction, Michael Jacobson, the Center for Science and the Public Interest. And also from one of my friends, Marion Nessel, who's a PhD in nutrition and writes a lot. Thanks, Mary. Yeah, Marion Nessel. She's a friend. She's been at the Advanced Study Weekend. And Michael Jacobson, Center for Science and the Public Interest. This is from our paper today, the Press Democrat. And here it is. I don't know whether that reads backwards for me. Does it read backwards for you?
No, actually, it shows it correct. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
It can read.
Well, anyway, Snack CEO vows to feed the truth. And, I have every reason to believe, particularly since this person, Lubitsky, excuse me for the pronunciation, especially since he's associated with Michael Jacobson, Center for Science and the Public Interest, and Marion Nessel, I have to believe that these people are telling the truth and heading in the correct direction. But that doesn't mean that they don't need some help leading the parade. And as I mentioned, at nearly 70 years old, I'm not slowing down. I just want to get a chance to get ahead of the parade and maybe give it a chance to go in a direction that I believe in. Whereas the parade is on, ladies and gentlemen, the marches are going on. The question is whether or not, whether or not the leaders are stepping forward.
Right.
But the question, and of course, I have very strong beliefs, and my intention is to be at the head of the parade.
Yes.
The head of the marches.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Very good. Very good. That's really good news, Dr. McDougall. You know, there are people here, and basically we can condense a lot of these questions because everybody has a relative or a friend who has type 2 diabetes, and they say, no, type 2 diabetes cannot be cured. So, you know, for these people that are asking, how can I tell them that it is cured? Do you believe that it would be the best approach would be to send these people to your videos, your newsletters, rather than the person themselves trying to convince them and not being successful?
I
What
don't
would you say?
know. Certainly I've given you the foundation, and Mary
You
and I and the
have.
rest of the team, we've given you the foundation. I don't know how best you can use the information. It kind of depends on what your background is. We have people listening who are school teachers, you
Right.
know, how to educate. We have people listening who are financiers. They know how to make money. We have generals who know how to run armies. We have people with movie star bodies that make an impression. You know, you have many talents, you folks do. And what you need to do, what I ask you to do, is use whatever you were given in terms of your communication abilities, and rely upon my information, at least as a place to start. You don't have to say Dr. McDougall is right, or I believe he's true, or he's not up for questioning. That's not the issue. You just say that he's worth the trouble to listen to
Right.
and to counter for me. And yeah, but to answer your question, or the public's question, yours too, Gustavo, because I know you've been there and I've been there, is how do you best approach those who you love and care about?
Right.
And there are all kinds of techniques. Doug Lyle, who was here last week, he tells you that he tells you to tell your friends so you don't lose your friends. It works for me. That's the way it works for Mary too. She's nearly 71, and she stands up on stage, and I have no doubt, or maybe I'm so blinded by bias that I can't see. But I my guess is people look at her and they go, my goodness, if I could look that nice at 71, if I could feel that good, she'll be skiing with the grandkids in about 3 days. Likely
I
I'll
know.
stay at the bottom of the hill, but
Oh,
she'll be out and at 71. And by the way, these are black diamonds. The grandkids will be going down. You know, people kind of look at Mary and they go, well, and Mary says, well, works for me. But then again, you may have my abrasiveness, my aggressiveness, which I'm not going to change. And you may say, well, my technique is get into people's face, make them look at it, whatever. Use your skills. It's worth the trouble for you, your loved ones, your spouse, your friends, your children, your parents, your country, your community, planet, whatever.
well, if anything, it's good for your own conscience to just know that you presented that information. Then the other you are not in control of what the person does with that information. And that I always have in mind. I don't want to be told another time in the future, why you knew this information, why didn't you tell me?
Yeah,
Okay,
yeah,
here it is.
yeah. And I we run into that all the time. I do as a doctor. I do as a friend, as a family member. You kind of look back and say, well, why didn't I try harder? I mean, they lost their
Right.
legs. Now they have
Exactly.
breast cancer or colon cancer. Why didn't I try harder? And you feel a little guilty. And then the other thing that happens is people come up to you, and I had this today. Let me see if I can remember his name. Well, I do, and I could show you the email. But let's just, for privacy issues, let's just, his initials are JA. I do know his name. You can find him under the Star McDougallers. And he tells a story about how life changed for him 16 years ago. I know this because he wrote me today. He said, I write you every year on my anniversary to tell you about my life and you know, to thank you, which I never get tired of hearing. He said, well, here it has been. Today he wrote me. This is February 16th, 2017. He wrote me an email today, and JA said, It has been 16 years since I've lost 100 pounds. And he also expressed the frustration that you're sharing, Gustavo, with me. And that is, he has, by the way, his wife's gone along on the same journey, but you know, his frustration of, well, why couldn't I help more people? Well, you have. Just your presence, just your story has helped. And you've helped me make it to the next day also, because I feel so good because I've helped you. You know, the greatest joy in life is helping other people. Anyway, just keep at it, folks. Don't give up. You can't give up. It's not like you have an option. I'll give up and go hide. But the world won't let you hide. So step up to the plate, do your job. I'll be right there with you. Mary will be with you. Gustavo will be with you. Our team, the Centers for Science and the Public Interest, Marion Nessel, Physicians Committee for Responsible Medicine, we'll all be there. We're not going to, yeah, we're not going to step down and say, oh, this is not worth fighting, and the liars were right. The liars are liars. You know, it ain't going to change. Well, let's go on to the next question.
You know, and you never know who you help. That's the other thing with today's technology. Yeah. Dr. McDougall, there's someone here who has a question. I think it's a really good question. Let's say someone with type 2 diabetes who has been 15 years or more and vegan for 2 years, what could they be doing wrong, or what could they do better in their diet, because they're saying that their daily sugar levels are not getting better? What fine tuning can they do?
Well, there are two issues, and it's worth the trouble to remind you, and we discussed these at the beginning of the webinar. First of all, they may not have type 2 diabetes. They may have 1.5 diabetes. Second of all, they may not have lost the weight, the body fat, which is causing insulin resistance, which creates type 2 diabetes. When you get down to trim body weight, and that's discussed in my November 2015 newsletter, there's a chart from Walter Kempner. I'll believe you'll find it there, a chart of what trim body weight is. I am 6 foot tall. I am fewer than 150 pounds. So, you know, there's one example. I know he's too thin. Well, whatever. Until you get to be, quote, too thin, then you cannot declare failure in terms of diabetes, because type 2 diabetes is 100% curable. Everybody knows that by definition, it's 100% curable. So if you haven't lost the weight that's causing the type 2 diabetes, then you can't declare failure. And you may not have type diabetes. You may have type 1.5 diabetes. Review the beginning of the discussion. Review the video that's on my website about the latest scams from the diabetes industry. Review the January 2017 newsletter. Go to my website, look under Hot Topics Diabetes, review 20, 30 articles that I've written over the last 15 years. Mm-hmm. And
but it is possible, Dr. McDougall, it is possible, correct, to be vegetarian or even vegan and eat a diet that is as high in fat as someone who is not a vegetarian or vegan, and that can include oils and many other processed foods, correct?
Oh, absolutely not just correct. It's common.
It's very common.
There are lots of vegans out there.
So this person commenting here, that may be something to look at when they look at their daily diet. Am I consuming oils? That are hidden there, or is the diet too high in fat?
The diet, you know, the diet is potatoes.
Right.
And water.
Without oil or cheese.
Without oil. That's as simple as it can get. Potatoes and water. That's as simple as it get, or as complex as it can get, is 1 or 3,000 recipes that Mary's published over the last 40 years. And pretty much all of them are free. We have the McDougall Cookbook app, which has 123 recipes for $4.99. sense. if you sit there and say, this guy is selling us something, this is a gimmick. What I recommended is you go to Costco and you buy 20 pounds of potatoes for $9.95. That's what I'm recommending. And anyway,
right.
Like I say, it's all a picture book. It's published in soon Italian. It's published in many languages as books, or it's free on my website under Dr. McDougall's color picture book, How to Cure Food Poisoning, which is what you're suffering, how to cure food poisoning by eating beans, corn, rice, potatoes, mm-hmm. sweet potatoes. It is free.
Right, right. Dr. McDougall, in your lecture, you mentioned something about some of the medical, some of the diabetes prescription drugs that people take actually causing weight gain. Can you just, why some people are not losing the weight?
Oh yeah, that's definitely a big part of it. If you treat diabetes with insulin, sulfonylureas, or other medications that increase the amount of insulin in your body, and those are listed in my January 2017
right.
newsletter
exactly.
for free.
That,
if you look at the medications that increase insulin, like insulin shots, of course, increase insulin. Sulfonylureas make the pancreas make more insulin. There are various drugs that make more insulin. Insulin forces fat into fat cells. And so when a patient starts on diabetic medications, often, not always, in fact, the pitch from some of the drugs is, well, we don't make you fatter. Well, excuse me, we do make you sicker. if a drug is, one of its effects is to raise insulin, then you're likely to gain weight, and as you gain weight, you become more diabetic. Every doctor has told you that when we're dealing with type 2 diabetes. Yeah, it's a scam. It's a multi-billion-dollar a year scam that hurts and kills millions of people. And did I say that? Could I say that in front of a court of law? Would you give me the opportunity to say that in front of the Senate? I doubt it. The way you deal with Dr. McDougall is you do not give him the stage. No matter how much evidence, how much research, how much credibility, how much truth there is, just don't give him the stage.
That's right. That's right. But Dr. McDougall, you will get the stage. Things are changing. And I am, well, at least I am hopeful.
You're hopeful, but those of you who know me know my goal, my
right.
primary goal. I don't mind the stage, but my primary goal is not to gain the stage. I just want to win. I just want to win when it comes to my grandchildren's future, when it comes to my patients. Plain and simple, ladies and gentlemen, I just want to win.
Whether you're on the given the stage or not, you just want to win.
I prefer to be not on the stage. why should I go through that much pain? I'd like to kind of sit back and watch. I just like to watch the Patriots win. You know,
that's right.
I don't have to be quarterback. I just want my team to win. And no particular preference to any sports team. anyway.
Dr. McDougall, there is the other day we received an email that explains how there is a new way of finding the recipes on your website, and it is truly awesome. And I'm just saying that because some people are saying, well, I can't eat beans, or I don't like this, or I don't like that. Well, there are thousands of recipes there, and they're available like that with a click of a mouse, and people can have all sorts of variety in their diets.
You know, I know, Gustavo, you'll put that up as a link.
I will.
For the
will.
Webinar.
And, and then AJ is here on the webinar, and she says that she achieved her goal weight eating potatoes. And I cannot agree more with her, because that's how I lost all my weight, just eating potatoes with salsa and ice.
Well, AJ is a very, very special person in my life, and you're in Loma Linda with her, and next week we're going to be in Sacramento. I think the event is sold out.
Right.
But when it comes to people that I'll look back on and say, you know, that person really added to my life, it would be AJ. Of course, the list goes on, but
It is,
yeah,
as we.
AJ is a well, amazing teacher, and she, what do they call it, truthiness or truthfulness, or she's that problem that I have and you have and a few others of you have, and that is you just have this unnecessary, no, it is necessary. I need to tell the truth. Yeah, that's
Yeah,
kind of a
there's
problem.
no other choice. Yes.
Well,
Well, Dr. McDougall.
there is another choice,
Well,
Gustavo,
for
and a lot of people are making
yes.
that too.
For some of us, it's like there's just no other choice. We just have to, in our own way, with our own personalities, have to bring this truth up front. Dr. McDougall, do you have any other comments you want to make or any
No,
other announcement?
if I could see the time, then I would
It's
tell you to.
11:45.
Oh, this has been a good 45 minutes, Gustavo,
Yes,
and
it has.
I know you busy traveling to Kauai and graciously given time to meet to get to know you a little better. You've been at the event; it's been a big deal for you. You've been traveling a lot, and people don't realize how much effort that you spend. Well, maybe some do, but most don't. How much effort you spend putting this webinar together and other webinars for people such as Chef AJ. And I would say we've done our job for the week. What do you think?
I cannot agree more. Well, Dr. McDougall, thank you again for being here. And oh, I just want to let people know, because people ask me from time to time. I will include a link for those of you who want. It's free. It's for those of you who want to watch the concert that I'm giving on Saturday here in Loma Linda.
Oh,
It's
good.
going to be broadcast worldwide, which I didn't know until yesterday. So I'm going to practice some more. but I'll include it there.
I'm going to watch. I
And
look forward to it.
also, if anybody is in the Sacramento area, oh, I guess it is sold out, but
It's sold. I think it's
anyway,
sold out.
there is a way, I think, that people can watch it online, and it's easily found if they type Healthy Taste of Sacramento on the website.
Yeah. We're also doing one in Texas, and
That's right, in Marshall. Yes, Marshall
right
County.
next. Yeah, we're going to do that. What is it? April probably.
That is May 31st, April 1st and 2nd. That's the weekend, and I'll be there. And
Yeah, I don't know that.
we don't get this kind
I
of
don't think that's sold out.
things in Texas. So anybody who lives in Texas, this is a great opportunity. You will be talking. Your son Greg, I believe, is going to be there,
Greg will be talking, and
and
so will
Mary as
Mary.
well. Yeah, so great event. Well, thank you everybody for logging in, and we'll see you. Well, we'll talk about next week. I don't know if you will be able to do the webinar from the mountains.
I will be able to do the webinar. I will
Okay.
definitely be able to do the webinar, unless, of course, something
Right.
unexpected comes on, and I will have enjoyed the morning with my 2-year-old Logan and my 4-year-old Chloe, and maybe I'll have time to spend with my 5-year-old Sam and my 3-year-old Nolan. They'll be down at the bottom of the hill with Grandpa. Now, if you want to go up the hill with Jason, Ben, and Ryan and Mary, and Brant and Heather, then you will have to get your skis on and your board on, anyway, I'll be there. I'll be there.
Well,
Okay,
good. We
good.
look forward to
Great pleasure.
it.
Have a
As
good week,
usual.
you
Thank you.
folks. Okay, bye-bye.
Very good. Well, goodbye, everybody. We'll see you next week then. And thank you, Dr. McDougall. Bye-bye.
Thank you, Gustavo.